You're all very welcome to any of Owen and Ciara. Can I ask you all please just remain in your seats and seated as we welcome in our bridal party this afternoon. Can I ask you first of all, put your hands together and welcome our junior bridesmaid Sarah, our bridesmaid Sarah Louise, and our groomsman Michael. Put your hands together, welcome our bridesmaid Kirsty, our groomsman Gary. Our chief bridesmaid today, Charlie, our best man today, Mr. Paul McGovern. And now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the management and staff here at the hotel, I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate Ciara and Owen on this occasion of their wedding and to wish them many years of happiness and success in their future lives together. And now, if I ask you all, please, just to be upstanding, put your hands together to welcome in our bride and our groom and give you the brand new Mr. and Mrs. Owen Murphy. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Has to take a seat for a few moments. Owen and Ciara today requested that the speeches are prior to dinner. They've asked me if I would chair the wedding speeches for them. So without further ado, can I ask you please put your hands together for the first speaker this afternoon, the father of the bride, Mr. Donald McGovern.
You can be sure this is going to be a short speech. Firstly, on behalf of my wife and Bernadette, I would like to thank everyone for coming here today to celebrate the marriage of our daughter Ciara to Owen. Ciara, as most of you know, is the baby of the house. She has a habit of playing this card when she's looking for something. So I have to tell her she lost all those rights when Sarah came along. I would like to say, Ciara, you've grown into a beautiful young woman, and I'm so proud of you and all your achievements, like abseiling down the Europa and more. You've come a long way from the time we fell down the stairs. I've gotten to know Owen and his mother, Sally, very well over the past few years, and I'd like to welcome them both into the family. Owen is indeed a well-mannered and hard-working young man, and I'm very proud to have Owen as my son-in-law. And I know that it is his life to make Ciara and Sarah happy. I just want to wish Ciara, Owen and Sarah a long and happy life together. Could you all please now be upstanding and we'll toast. To the bride and groom.
Well done, Dawn. Ladies and gentlemen, Cassie, please put your hands together for our best man, Mr. Paul McGovern.
Good afternoon, everyone. For those of you who don't know me, I am Paul, Kira's brother. Just a few rules before we begin. If you have a mobile phone, keep it on, keep yourselves entertained. Anyone sends any good jokes, text message any good jokes, send them my way to you. So I'd like to take this opportunity just to thank Owen for asking me to be his best man. Even though when he first asked, I wasn't sure if it was a serious text message or not. When I did realise it was a genuine message, though, I got a bit nervous. But that's only because the second message says I better read the speech that he had wrote for me. Although the nerves didn't last very long, because the day I see him run around Todd's Leap, dressed as a cheerleader with long blonde pigtails, he seemed a bit less threatening. And I have the photos on my phone to prove it. So now, while I was writing this speech, I was talking to a few married men just to ask if they had any tips for Owen, so his marriage would run nice and smoothly. So if you follow these tips, you'll be all right. A marriage is a relationship where one person is always right, and the other is always the husband. And if at first you don't succeed, try doing it the way Kira told you to do it. If Kira ever says to you, "What?" It's not that she didn't hear you. She's giving you a chance to change your mind. Just one more thing. Now that you're married, you can just drop the whole Mr. and Mrs. McGovern. You're officially part of the Donald and Bin Club. Joking aside, I'd like to officially welcome Owen to the family. Very welcome. I also want to say, and I think everybody here will agree, all the bridesmaids are looking stunning today. Kira and Sarah, both looking gorgeous. Well, I'm not going to tell you that you're gorgeous. I will tell you, you've got yourself a lovely wife and my wee sister Kira. Kira, you've got a great husband. On behalf of myself and Donna, I'd like to wish you all the best for the future, and we hope you, Kira, and Sarah have a great day today. I hope you have a long and happy life together. So if everyone, we could all just raise a toast to the bride and groom this evening.
Well done, Paul. Good job. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Welcome our group. That's our own group.
Cheers very much, guys. Gordon. Huh? Gordon. I get that yet. So, on behalf of me and my wife, I would like to... I've been waiting to say that for ages. Like to welcome us all here. And we got a lot of stick about a speech I was supposed to write, but as you can see, it's literally in the back of a Gordon's chemistry seat, which I wrote this morning, so it's going to be short and sweet. I don't know. I knew I should have wrote a speech out. Anyway, I'd just like to thank everybody for being here. Sincerely, I appreciate the effort you've made. I know a lot of you have travelled very far. Kieran, you guys, and Kirsty, Canada. I have Australians here who the first meeting I had threw stuff over me in the back of my trailer. Thanks for that, by the way. Appreciate it. I'm nearly glad to see this all coming to fruition now. Kier's been crazy for the past year planning this thing. My head's been tortured. But it's good fun, like. No problem. No problem. But she has been class at it, like, everything just went down to a T. Pictures, video men, cars, everything. I didn't know anything about what was happening. But she's organised the whole thing to perfection, so it was class. Well done, Kier.
Where do you get the
buzz? I've genuinely never been as excited over a day. Something I thought I was never going to come around, like, from last year, proposing over in Lanzarote, even though it wasn't Canada, which we planned, but sure. They wouldn't let me in, but we'll not get into that. I don't know. But, No, that's not a joke. You don't have to laugh at that one. I didn't get in. Try again. No, but seriously, I've been welcomed in this family from day one with open arms, and just want to appreciate it and say, let you know, I appreciate it very much. Don, Bertie, and the rest of the guys too. Not forget about you. I was made feel very welcome from day one, so thank you for that. I know, Mama, you weren't looking forward to this day because you don't like the whole makeup and hair thing and all that jazz. You're tortured. But you don't scroll up too bad, to be fair. You know? No, but I appreciate everything you've done for me, Mum. We've come a long way. We've had highs, we've had lows. We've been up and down and laughed and cried. But I appreciate you being here today, and have a good night anyway. Love you. Paul's already complimented the bridesmaids how good they look, so I don't know if I have to do it again, but yous are actually looking stunning, like, yous are class. I know, Charlie, you're up late night cleaning. You're busy at it, you know. Kirsty's coming from Canada, so she's been working hard and looking well. Well, Weezy, you're ready to go anytime. But no, yous genuinely, yous all look, yous are class. Yous turned out well, not bad. And as for Kira, the drama of the hard work she's put in all year, of the boxing, the dieting, I have to admit, like, she looks amazing. Genuinely a very happy, lucky man. So here's to Kira and a happy marriage. I don't know if I'm supposed to toast that, anyway, but cheers, guys. That'll do me. Cheers, Mum.
Just before we commence the dinner, ladies and gentlemen, Kira's going to make a presentation to Owen's mum, Sally. And Owen is going to make a presentation to Kira's mum, Bernadette. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the formalities for this part of the evening. Put your hands together for all on the top table. You all spoke so very well. Well done. We're about to serve dinner. Can I ask you all please to stand and we'll say a very brief grace before dinner is served. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Bless the Lord, bless his food, put us all in a happy mood. Bless the chefs and those who serve us, and from indigestion, O Lord, preserve us. Dinner will be served. Enjoy dinner. Thank you.